for 200 years now, starting with Thomas Robert Malthus. Demographers have been sounding the alarm that there isn't enough space and resources on Earth, and that there's an oversupply of people. But what if the Earth belonged to the class of planets called super-Earths and had a mass and size 2 or even 10 times larger? Would it solve all of our problems? Or, on the contrary, would terrible consequences await us? According to the assumptions of Mickey Rosenthal from the University of California, Santa Cruz, our planet had every chance of becoming a super-Earth. But this was prevented by Jupiter, which blocked the Earth's access to additional building material that could have made it much larger. If it weren't for Jupiter, the Earth would have grown, and almost everything on our planet would have shrunk several times over. And this is not a matter of proportions at all, but one of enhanced gravity. To overcome it, it would take a lot more energy. Therefore, buildings that are too tall, such as the Burj Khalifa in the United Arab Emirates, would collapse, and humanity would forever abandon skyscrapers. Trees, mountains, animals, and people would also become shorter. But their weight would be much greater. If you weigh now, say, 75 kilograms or 165 pounds, then on a super-Earth with double Earth's mass, your weight would increase to 150 kilograms or 330 pounds, and up to 750 kilograms or 1,650 pounds if our planet was 10 times more massive. But these are far from the worst consequences of increased gravity. Meteorites and large asteroids, in this case, would fall to Earth much more often. This, of course, would solve the problem of overpopulation until the complete extermination of humanity. Due to stronger gravity, the density of the atmosphere would increase, which would likely reduce its thickness and affect atmospheric pressure. High atmospheric pressure, along with gravity, would lead to the destruction of mountain systems. There would be fewer beautiful mountain landscapes, but there would be a large number of islands that could be inhabited by people and animals. In truth, it would be very difficult to conquer space from such a planet. And again, due to gravity. Under normal conditions, a spacecraft such as the Falcon Heavy from SpaceX is capable of delivering up to 50,000 kilograms or 110,000 pounds of usable weight into Earth's orbit. If the mass of the Earth was close to that of Kepler-20b, that is almost 10 times greater, then the same Falcon would be able to take no more than 40 kilograms or 88 pounds into orbit, about the weight of an adult German Shepherd. Current technology would allow us to take off from a supermassive planet, but it would be very expensive, difficult, and unproductive. In addition, increased gravity would increase the pressure in the Earth's core, which would lead to cooling of the liquid part of the core. This means that the magnetic field protecting us from solar wind could disappear forever. Anyone who survived the frequent meteor showers would be killed by radiation. Another problem associated with increased pressure within a super-Earth is volcanic activity. In the bowels of such a large planet, a lot of energy accumulates, which simply needs to go somewhere. The easiest way is through volcanic eruptions. Their frequency would be so high that hardly anyone would be able to live near volcanoes. Given the effect of volcanic activity on the climate, the viability of the planet would have to be forgotten. The atmosphere would become warmer than one of the most terrible dreams of Greta Thunberg. Or vice versa, the volcanic smog would block the sunlight, and all living things would freeze and die. However, volcanoes on such a planet are sometimes exclusively underwater. Indeed, most well-known super-Earths are completely covered in water without a single hint of a hard surface. Solid ocean may seem like a reasonable option. Humanity might somehow adapt. But life can't appear in such water. Due to the high pressure, the ocean floor would be covered with a thick layer of ice, which would make the carbon cycle and mineral exchange between the atmosphere and the bowels of the planet impossible. In fact, according to Hilke Schlichting from the University of California, Los Angeles, if our planet was a super Earth, all the water would simply evaporate. According to her assumption, the super Earth would rotate much closer to the sun in orbit, making a complete revolution in only 100 days. Such an orbit is considered habitable if the star is smaller than our sun. But at such a distance from our sun, all the water on a super Earth would simply evaporate. Rodrigo Luger from the Center for Computational Astrophysics at the Flatiron Institute suggests that all super Earths evaporate, except that instead of steam, they turn into liquid water. He believes that super Earths are formed from separate pieces of ice. Then they migrate closer to their star, the ice melts, and an ocean appears, completely covering the surface of the planet. Perhaps such planets are the most common in the universe. Among the more than 4,000 exoplanets discovered by the Kepler Space Telescope, about 30% fall in the super-Earth class. If we want to migrate in search of a better place to live, we need to focus exclusively on super-Earths. After all, the remaining 70% are gas giants. And if you have the choice, it's better to live on a planet with increased gravity than to melt or freeze on a gas giant. Every time scientists discover another super-Earth, news publications are full of headlines stating that extraterrestrial life has finally been found. But there's always a huge but. Scientists place their highest hopes on Proxima Centauri b. In truth, it's not a super Earth. Its theoretical mass and size are not much larger than our Earth's. However, all hopes of its vitality collapsed when a heavy-duty flash occurred on its star, destroying all of its alleged life. Another likely candidate for relocation is GJ357D. This super-Earth is located about 31 light-years from Earth. It has 6 times the mass of the Earth and is twice its size. This one makes a complete revolution around its star in 55.7 days and is 5 times closer to its star than the Earth is to the Sun. Since its star is 3 times smaller and lighter than our Sun, and also 40% colder, its habitable zone is much closer. Diana Kasakowski, a researcher at the Max Planck Institute for Astronomy in Germany, believes there may be liquid water on planet GJ357D, so she plans to search for other signs of life on it in the near future. A little further, at a distance of 39 light-years from Earth, is another super-Earth, GJ180D. It's 7.5 times larger than the Earth, but its main feature is unique. Most exoplanets are tidally locked, meaning the same side always faces its star, like the Moon towards the Earth. This makes it impossible to form the magnetic field necessary for the emergence of life. GJ357D is not tied to its star. Therefore, it has a much higher chance of being inhabited. Another candidate, GJ229A, is closer, 19 light-years from Earth. It has 7.9 times the mass of the Earth, and in 122 Earth days, it makes a complete revolution around its star. More precisely, around its stars, because in the center of the system are 2 stars together, a brown and a red dwarf. Still, scientists have found candidates for life among other types of planets. For example, K2-18b. It's considered a super-Earth, but its composition is more like a mini-Neptune. This is an intermediate class of planets that are a cross between cold gas giants like Neptune or Uranus and terrestrial planets. Mini-Neptunes have rocky cores hidden under a thick gas shell. Planet K2-18b has the mass of a super-Earth, but its low density makes it a mini-Neptune. It's noteworthy that it was on this planet that signs of liquid water were first discovered on a super Earth. This, in turn, gave astronomers hope that somewhere outside our solar system, there could be life. However, life didn't appear on a super Earth, but on ordinary Earth. Despite the small size of our planet, it has many more advantages than if it were a super Earth. Would you prefer to be on a super Earth with super gravity? Tell us in the comments. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already, and click the bell in time to receive notifications of new interesting videos that await you ahead. Until next time.